If you're looking for a great chicken recipe you can make out on the grill or in home on the kitchen, you can make these fresh herb chimichurri chicken kebabs. I got that all right. We have Cindy Barbieri here, chef and cookbook author from cindystable.com. Cindy, look at all this stuff.
I know.
There's so much stuff going on
here.
There's
so much stuff, but it's all fresh herbs, which most of us have fresh herbs gardens. So let's use up what we have in our garden. So normally chimichurri is parsley, okay, with lemon and shallots and garlic and olive oil and red pepper flakes. So that's a basic chimichurri. But we're going to bring it up a notch, and we're going to add some other herbs in it. So I already started with some basil in my food processor. From my garden this morning, I cut everything fresh before I got here. And then we're going to add in some parsley. And if you want to break apart some more parsley, you can.
How do you break apart
parsley? You know, you just use your hand and just kind of do a twist.
I was going individually. No, I was
just
trying
do
to
a twist.
That. Okay.
And then I have some mint here, so I'm going to add in. So I'll do some mint.
When you were picking these this morning, how did you know they were good to go for the show?
Because they were nice and green and beautiful. So that's how I knew. So, okay, so I'm going to add in some mint. Now, this right here is thyme, right here. This is already broken apart. I'll just toss it in there. But let me just show you how you break it apart, because we don't want the stem inside there. So what you do is you have it holding up like this. Just grab your, put your finger right there, and then just give it a light press down.
Oh, okay.
And see how it just comes right out.
You're, like, pushing
it
all off the stem.
Right.
Now, which one of these is the strongest you have to, like, be aware of? You know, like, when you make a smoothie, the banana's super strong?
Yeah, so probably the rosemary and the mint.
Okay.
So you don't have to use both. You know, I just wanted to bring all these amazing fresh herbs with today. So you don't have to use the rosemary. I love thyme and the basil and the parsley. I love a little bit of mint, too, with the chicken. It really adds a lot of great flavor. So we have our herbs in. So I already cut up a couple of cloves of garlic. So, you know, you don't have to do it fancy. Just the food processor will do all the work.
Yeah.
And then I have a shallot that I just peeled and sliced. Then we'll add in some salt and pepper.
Can never go wrong.
Never go wrong with
that. We're going to make the chicken later on. Right now we're making the sauce,
We're just going to make the sauce right
now,
and this is going to marinate the chicken kebabs.
Okay.
So now I get some lemon zest. So first you want to zest your lemon first. Okay, so we're just
going to zest. This is a two-part lemon technique.
It is a two-part.
We don't waste any lemon.
We don't waste anything in our kitchen here. So then I just slice the lemon in half, and then I'm just going to squeeze it. And I'm holding my hand just to collect any of those seeds.
You don't want any seeds getting in there.
We don't want anybody to get a seed, no.
Okay.
Okay, so now we did that part. So I'm going to add in just a few red pepper flakes just to give it a little bit of heat, so extra flavor. And then I'm just going to pour in some olive oil.
How did you come up with all this? There's so much ingredients
but
here.
But it's so easy, really. Everything I just picked outside. So now I just put the food processor on, and I can be adding in some more.
Why do you add more oil in there?
Because I don't want it to be a paste. If you look at what we already made, it's right here,
Danny. The after photo right here for you guys.
The after photo is right here. So I just put it in a nice, pretty jar so we can serve it. But see the consistency of this?
It's almost like a really light salsa.
Like a sauce, almost.
Yeah.
It's like a sauce. So we can put this over chicken, over fish, over pork, anything we want. Even on toast, if you want like a little baguette.
You put it on toast?
Oh, absolutely. You can do anything you want. And I know earlier you were smelling this, and the whole station smells amazing.
Everyone's coming around like, what is that smell?
It smells so great in here with all these ingredients. You know, everything just is going to be amazing. And we're going to actually marinate our chicken kebabs in this. And if you marinate it for a couple of hours, it just goes right into the chicken, and it's going to add so much great flavor to this. And it's so easy to make. I mean, look at in just a few seconds, we were able to make this great sauce.
Do you marinate in the fridge or?
Oh, absolutely in the refrigerator. No, we're going to put it in the fridge, cover it up after we make the kebabs, and we'll show you how to do it a little later. And it's just going to add so much more flavor. And we can grill it inside or outside.
Yes.
And within minutes, you're going to have a great dish.
Now, when you do marinate it, do you just brush it on there, or do you actually, like, put it inside?
No.
Do you submerge it?
So we're actually going to make the kebabs, and we're going to just brush it with the chimichurri, and then we're going to save some for later. So when we're serving it, we'll put this in a nice, pretty jar, and you can add more to it.
And I would think it's pretty healthy, too, right?
Oh,
a lot
absolutely.
Of great vegetables.
Look at everything in
here.
We have all of these great herbs that are fresh. You know, the salt and pepper, the lemon juice. And if you want to add lime, you can add lime as well. The shallots and the garlic. I mean, all these ingredients are so healthy. Everything is local right here in Massachusetts. So everything is just going to be so much flavorful.
Yeah. A beautiful local dish. We're going to take this later on and put it on some chicken, make some kebabs inside. But you could make it outside.
Absolutely.
And if you can make it outside, you're going to need some good weather, which is why we need 22 News Storm Team Meteorologist Nick Bannon. We are back in the kitchen with Cindy Barbieri, chef and cookbook author from cindystable.com, finishing up our fresh herb chimichurri chicken kebab. I got that down.
You did.
I memorized that well.
Great, yes.
I've said it so many times. Okay, so now we're grilling inside.
Yes, we're going to grill inside, and we're going to make the kebabs.
Okay.
Okay, so we did the chimichurri.
We made our little sauce. You guys remember the chimichurri sauce we made together.
So that is made. So now, Deanna, you see how we have the kebab sticks in water.
Why are they in water?
Okay. Now, you can use the metal ones, but I love the wood ones because they're smaller, they're easier to store in the refrigerator if you make them in advance. If you put them in water for 30 minutes, they will not burn when you grill. If you take a dry stick and kebab anything, any kind of meat or vegetables, I will guarantee you that it'll burn in the grill. It'll actually like char. And it won't look pretty, and the food can actually fall off. So the peppers could fall off and things like that. So you don't want that to happen. So 30 minutes in some water.
That's easy.
It's really easy to do. Now what I like to do is put all my kebab ingredients into one skewer. So this way you have the meat and the vegetables, okay? Mm-hmm. So we want to keep them all the same size. That's real important, okay? So if you see, I got my boneless chicken breasts here. See how these are basically all the same size. So that means they'll cook at the same time. So we want everything done at once, okay?
Are you cubing them?
Yeah, we're just going to put them into bite-sized cubes. So when you take them off the skewer, you can just eat them. Maybe, you know, cut them in half or put them in pita bread or eat them over a salad, however you want. But you don't want to give them a big chunk of chicken. You want just some nice bites of meat.
Yeah.
So I trimmed around the chicken, and I just cut it into cubes, okay? And then we just want to, you know, season it with salt and pepper. Okay, so you want to season it good. You always season your meat. Now, if you notice, I have two cutting boards. So here I have a white plastic board, and then I have the wood board.
Why?
So you always want to prepare poultry on a plastic board. And for the main reason is, you know, you don't want to have any disease go through from the chicken to the meat. We don't want anybody to get sick, okay?
This is a disease control thing.
Absolutely. You don't want E. coli. And this can go right in the dishwasher. Okay, so we know it's going to be clean and cleansed and ready to use again. So it's really for safety reasons. You don't want to get your kids sick or anybody, your friends or family that come over to eat.
Yes.
You don't want to get them sick.
Cindy's keeping you safe, guys.
Absolutely. So that's why I have this on a plastic board. So I have the chicken, you know, seasoned and all that. So now I'll just move that over. So I already peeled a couple of onions. So all I'm going to do is cut them in pretty big slices here.
Because you want everything to be consistently sized.
Absolutely, right. We want everything to be sized. So now here are the peppers. Now I have a nice ceramic knife, which is very sharp, so please be careful.
I'm very careful. Everyone at home knows how careful I am.
So what we want to do is how I cut a pepper, I'll just show you and then you can go. So what I do is I just kind of go along the edge, so I'm going to have a nice slice, and that's going to be a perfect size for me to cube.
How much do you cut? So you cut that into cubes? How many does this make? How many sizes does this make?
That'll make a couple, maybe
make
two
couple.
Or three.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, now I'm gonna
so you do that, and then I'll take this knife.
Careful.
And I can make three.
How am I doing?
Is that you're like, doing? Yeah, you're doing awesome.
Oh my gosh, that is really sharp.
You're doing. It is really. It is very sharp. Ceramic is very sharp knife. Okay. So why don't you do the same to the green pepper, and I'll just move this out of the way here.
Okay. We don't have a lot of time left, so I want to make sure you see the finish.
So absolutely.
Product.
So let me just get one going. So I always start with a pepper because to me it's a good place to be. You know, to kind of hold it together.
Okay, that's a good start.
And then
point.
I'll add in some chicken. I love onion. I know my sister-in-law hates onion, so I always don't include. I know, Sharon, I would not put onion on for you.
She almost shout out.
Yes.
I like onions. I'll eat
so them. Now what I'm going to do is just kind of keep, you know, making my kebab. I can add more chicken and keep it going, okay? Now we have that chimichurri that we made. So what I'm doing, now normally I would marinate it like this, put it in the refrigerator for a couple of hours, but we're just going to put it right on our grill.
So you marinate it, and then you put it on the grill. Let's show them the finished product.
So here's the finished product. It's right here.
There's your fresh herb chimichurri chicken kebab. Nice little platter over here.
Yeah,
got a little lemon.
Ready to go.
A little bit of lettuce.
Yes, I add over a salad. And just one more tip, if I can give it. With tomatoes, I usually don't put those on with the kebab. So I would just put that on a separate kebab. This. And put
tomatoes
it on there.
On a separate kebab.
And let that cook like that. That's going to be beautiful. Beautiful way to serve a crowd.
Cindy, thank you so much for coming on the show.
Oh,
I appreciate it. You get all the information.
Me.
You get the recipe for the fresh herb chimichurri chicken kebab on mymassspiel.com.